Never let anybody in any hardware store, especially Bunnings, tell you you don't need a water trap, an S trap, in your sewage system, because the sewage doesn't smell. In any sewage system, before an inlet, where the water will flow in, be it a sink or a shower or whatever, you must have an S trap, that's an S trap or a water lock, before the inlet. Otherwise the gases will come up out the inlet, and that acts to stop the gases and to keep the gas in the sewage system, which is back toward the sewage system, and this is working forward to the outlet. So to be very specific, without the water lock, that would be the line and the gases would come straight out of the inlet there. So without the water lock, that would be the plumbing straight, but now it's the gases are stopped by the S trap. So I just want to say to people like Bunnings and other hardware stores, be very specific who you employ in your plumbing area. Okay, how to put a water lock or an S trap in a slab. I've just ground out this area here to provide access for the S trap, and I've sort of put little bits of cut down PVC that'll slot into the previous plumbing. That side's adjustable, and so I've put a small spacing ring of PVC around that slot, and that will sit over there. Then that will be pushed into the plumbing system like that to provide an outlet with a water lock. So there's the overflow there, and there's the toilet system there. Okay, so that's all in place. I push the plumbing up against this joint here, and this sleeve here slid into the what you see there, the right hand side. So now there's the water lock and the outlet. I'll just trim the outlet down when I resurface the floor. Okay, now I'm just about to pour in the cement. I've got new cement, never use old cement, it's been sitting around the house for a while. So there's my new cement. I've just purchased it from a shop for something as important as this. So now you can see there, I've got the water outlet there, and that's fixed in place. And what I'm going to do now is just put some self-leveling agent on the floor just to get it level with a slight fall toward the outlet there. I've got a piece of PVC there so the cement won't pour down the drainage system. Never forget, preparation is very important. I've scrubbed the cement with this very coarse sandpaper and a wire brush. There's the toilet base, and that's going to be connected to that hole there. can see underneath the toilet there, that's the toilet outlet. This connection here sits on the outlet, and that point there drains out the pipe. So I've primed the pipe and the outlet. You can see there the pink there. So now I'll glue the pipe and the outlet. Now I just push the pipe into the outlet. You can see there that the seal will sit inside the diameter of the pipe. I'll cut that off at ground level. Just going to prime the PVC. That's the first coat you put on. So now I'm going to glue the PVC and just set it so that when I put the toilet on it, it'll go down to the right level. Now the plumbing glue is dried, I'll lift the toilet off. So before I actually cement the toilet in place, I've made sure that everything fits. So you can see there the top of the toilet, that's the inlet valve and that's the outlet valve. You can see there underneath, that's the inlet valve, that's the bottom of the outlet valve, and they're the screws to hold it on to the toilet. So that the inlet valve connects to the main water, and the screws here hold that down into that flush system there. There's a rubber washer that removes, and that tightens up to hold the outlet valve there onto the system. And that's the bottom of the inlet valve, and that tightens up to hold the inlet valve there in the system so there's no leaks. There's a rubber washer there. There's the flush button. Okay, so I've got the toilet in position. I've got a line up line and I've got it marked on the toilet. You can see there. Now I'm just going to pencil around the toilet. Thank you. Okay, so now I've just got to attach the system. And I think if you look under there, you can just see the screw there. So now under there you can see the screw's tight. Now I have to connect the cistern water up with the mains water there. And I've got this tap that I attached to there. And this flexible plumbing tube here that I connect to the cistern. Now I'll just tighten up the plumbing connector. Okay, now I've just got to finish off. I've got a grout, white with white grout, underneath the toilet. There's the retaining hole there. That's sort of a dark colour. I'm going to make that white with white grout, and just underneath the shower. I've got the two connections for the pull-down blind installed. It's not easy because it's actually got metal from side to side. So if I need to trim it within the width of the window, I need to cut the metal. Now that that's trimmed for width, just get these stoppers and put them inside there. And that one slots in the same. Now I'll just trim the handrail. I've marked here how wide it has to be. Just go ahead and cut it. So you measure from there to there and trim the top. I've just installed this little rail around the kitchen bench there. That's just to catch any water or anything wet that may spill over the edge. That's just a piece of wood that I've painted with petrol based paint and just screwed into the side. You probably remember when I was making the kitchen, I had to trim the width of the kitchen, I had to trim the doors, that's left this wooden finish here, and I have to iron on some edging.